Good morning, students. Welcome in next lecture of Math F211. Online audio video is okay? Harish, Arju?
Yes.
Audio video is okay?
Yes.
So, presently we are doing Laplace transform. So, in continuous of that, in previous class, I have given you a hint that for the complex integration also, we use the Laplace transform. So let us have this question, question number 5a. If a and b are two constants, evaluate integral 0 to infinity e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx upon x into dx. So for such kind of the problem, always first, you have to identify what is the fx. So in this case, you assume fx is equal to e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx. So if you take the Laplace transform on both sides, so Laplace transform of the fx will be the Laplace transform of e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx. And standard formula, it is the 1 upon p plus a minus minus 1 upon p plus b. And that we rename as a FP. So actual function is e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx upon x. So we know that Laplace transform of fx upon x, if you divide by the x, so it is nothing. It is the integral p to infinity FP dp. So if you compute the Laplace transform of e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx upon x, it will become integral p to infinity of 1 upon p plus a minus 1 upon p plus b with respect to dp, right? Or with respect to p. So on integration, we know that first integration is ln of p plus a minus ln of p plus b. That can be written as ln of p plus a upon p plus b and limit p to infinity. So its answer will be the minus ln of p plus a upon p plus b. Now, from the left hand side, what is the formula of the L? L is the integral 0 to infinity e to power minus px fx into dx. Fx into dx. So you, and fx is what here? Fx is the e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx upon x. So on the left hand side, it will become integral 0 to infinity e to power minus px of the function. Function is e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx upon x into dx is equal to minus of ln of p plus a upon p plus b. Now, just if you put the p is equal to 0 in this, if you put p is equal to 0, you will get the integral 0 to infinity e to power minus ax minus e to power minus bx upon 2 dx is equal to minus ln of a upon b, which can be written as ln of b upon a. So in this way, we can integrate the given integral. Have you noted? For example, if you have to compute the integral of 0 to infinity e to power minus ax sin bx upon x, so first we know that what is the L of sin bx. L of sin bx is b upon p square plus b square. So L of fx, if you take the fx as a e to power minus ax into sin bx, so by first shifting theorem, it will become b upon p plus a plus b square. By first shifting theorem, you just note down, by first shifting theorem, L of e to power minus ax sin bx will become b upon p plus a whole square plus b square, and that we write as a FP. So L of fx upon x will become integral 0 to infinity FP dp, right? FP dp. So this will be the integral of the p to infinity, integral p to infinity of b upon p plus a whole square plus b square dp. It is the p to infinity. So its integration will be the b and that is the B tan inverse of P plus A upon B, and integral P to infinity that can be written as pi by 2 minus tan inverse of P plus A upon B, or tan inverse of B upon P minus A. Again, this can be written as integral 0 to infinity e to power minus px fx into dx, where fx is what? Fx is e to power minus ax sin bx upon x. So this will become, now when we put p is equal to 0, so that will give you tan inverse of b upon a. That is the, so in general, if you have to do the direct integration, it is very hard to do this type of integration, but through the Laplace easily you can do. Harish, any doubt? Harish, are you online?
No, sir.
Now, first of all, let us have this statement. If yx satisfies the differential equation y double dash plus x square y is equal to 0, where y0 is equal to y0 and y dash at 0 is equal to y0 dash, means these two are constant. These two are the constant. So that its transform yp satisfies the equation y double dash plus p square y is equal to p y naught plus y naught dash. Observe that second equation is of the same type as the first, so that no progress has been made. The method of example 3 is not advantageous. Is advantageous only when the coefficient of the first degree polynomial, right, is the coefficient are the first degree polynomial. So in this case, here we have the equation y double dash plus x square y is equal to 0. So if you take the Laplace on both sides, so we have the Laplace of y double dash plus Laplace of the x square y is equal to 0. And we know that Laplace of the y double dash is what? P square ly minus p y at 0 and minus y dash at 0. Minus now it is the dp2 of l of y. And l of y we represent as a capital Y. L of y we write the capital Y. So it will become d2y upon dp2 is equal to 0. So this will be the y double dash, capital Y double dash, plus p square capital Y is equal to p y naught plus y dash 0. So in this case, either you solve this equation or you solve this equation. In both, we have the y double dash plus x square y is equal to 0. Y double dash plus p square y is equal to something, means both are of same nature. So in such kind of the equation, there is no benefit for taking benefit on taking the Laplace. You have to solve the, means here the degree of the differential equation is not reducing. So if the coefficient of y is of second degree, there is no benefit to apply the Laplace transform. So that statement is written here. So conclusion from the book, same type of the differential equation as original, it is advantageous only when the coefficient are of first degree. Whatever the previous questions you have seen, in all we have the coefficient of the y as a first degree. If it is of second degree, there is no benefit to apply the Laplace transform. Now, some good question on the Laplace transform. What is the Laplace of the j naught x? So here Laplace of the j naught x is 1 upon root of p square plus 1. Then from here you have to find the integral 0 to infinity of the j naught x dx is equal to 1. That you have to prove. Sometimes in quiz type, we ask directly also these type of the question. So what is the integral of the 0 to infinity j naught x dx? So we know that what is the formula of the JP? JP is equal to summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 to power n xy 2 to power 2n plus 2p upon factorial n gamma of p plus n plus 0. What we have to compute? We have to compute the j naught, means p is equal to 0. So put p is equal to 0. So as you put the p is equal to 0, we have the summation n is equal to 0 to infinity minus 1 to power n x by 2 to power 2n upon factorial n gamma of n plus 1. And gamma of n plus 1 can be written as factorial n. So that's why here we have the factorial n square. Ultimately, the j naught x is what? 1 minus x square upon 2 square plus x to power 4 upon 2 square 4 square minus x to power 6 upon 2 square 4 square 6 square and so on. Now, if you take the Laplace on both sides, so Laplace of 1, because Laplace follow the linear property, L is linear, so it can be written as L of 1 minus 1 upon 2 square L of x square plus 1 upon 2 square 4 square L of x to power 4 and so on. L of 1 is 1 upon p, L of p square is, L of x square is factorial 2 upon p cube, L of x to power 4 is factorial 4 upon p to power 5 and so on. From all, if you take the 1 upon p common, and one more thing, this 2 is cancelled out, right? Here we have the factorial 4. So in this case, this 4 is cancelled with this 4, and remaining 1, 2, 3, 4 will cancel, and it will give you, right? And it will give you 1 into 3 upon 2 into 4, right? 1 into 3 upon 2 into 4, right? 2 and 2 cancel out. 1, 2 and 2 cancel out. This factorial 4 can be written as 1, 2, 3, 4. So this 4 and this 4 cancel out. This 2 and this 2 cancel out. So 1 into 3 upon 2 into 4. And this is nothing. This is the binomial expansion of 1 upon p square to power minus half. And as you write, this can be written as 1 upon root of 1 plus p square. So that is the Laplace of the j naught x. And this is what? Laplace of the j naught x. And Laplace is what? Integral 0 to infinity e to power minus px j naught x into dx. So that is written here. Integral 0 to infinity e to power minus px j naught x dx is equal to 1 upon root of p square plus 1. As you put p is equal to 0, you will get integral 0 to infinity j naught x dx is equal to 1. So that is a very standard formula, right? Very standard integral also. Now, prove Laplace of x into, this is in series only, all questions are related to each other. So, prove L of Laplace of the x into j naught ax is equal to p upon p square plus a square to power 3 by 2. So, we know that Laplace of x into something is nothing minus dy dp of the Laplace. On multiplying the x, whatever, if it is the x square, so minus 1 to power 2 d2 upon dp2 and so on. So minus dy dp of Laplace of j naught ax, and Laplace of the f of ax is what? It is the minus dy dp of 1 upon p square plus a square. So its value will be the, on derivative, you will get the p upon p square plus a square to power 3 by 2. Can I move? Now, in the question number 7, show that integral 0 to infinity sin xt upon t dt is equal to pi by 2. So, as you have the integral 0 to infinity, it means you are applying the Laplace. And there you are putting p is equal to 0. Right? This is the way to recognize here. So, L of sin xt, right? Sin of x into t. So, here the variable, they are assuming that t is the variable. T is the variable, x is the constant. Right? In general, we write the sin of ax as a upon p square plus a square. Now, they are writing the x as a constant, t as a variable. So, sin of x into t is equal to x upon p square plus x square. That we write as a fp. So, L of sin xt upon t, L of x sin xt upon t, that is the integral integral 0 to infinity. I think it should be the p to infinity. It is a p to infinity. So, p to infinity fp dp. So, integral p to infinity x upon p square plus x square dp. That can be written as x is the common and integral is 1 upon x tan inverse p upon x and p to infinity. That will give you tan inverse infinity minus tan inverse of p upon x or pi by 2 minus tan inverse of p upon x. And this Laplace can be written as integral 0 to infinity e to power minus pt f of t into dt because variable is t. So, this can be written as integral 0 to infinity e to power minus pt sin xt upon t dt is equal to pi by 2 minus p inverse of p upon x. As you put p is equal to 0. P is equal to 0. So, this will become the 0. So, only we have the pi by 2. Correct? Now, last thing. If the fx is a periodic function means it repeats after the fixed period. After a fixed period, if the fx is a periodic function, then how we can write the Laplace? If fx is the periodic with period a, so that f of the x plus a is equal to fx, means this length is the a. After the a, the curve will repeat. That is the periodic. So, f of the x plus a is equal to fx. So, that fp is equal to, if you take the fp is what? Fp is the Laplace of the fx. Laplace of the fx. And so, fp is equal to 1 upon 1 minus e to power minus ap integral 0 to a e to power minus px fx dx. Find fp of function fx is equal to 1 in the interval from 0 to 1, 2 to 3, 4 to 1, 4 to 5 and so on. And fx is equal to 0 in the remaining interval. So, first of all, how to determine the Laplace transform of the periodic function? So, L of x, basic formula is what? Integral 0 to infinity e to power minus px fx into dx. That is the basic formula. Now, this integral can be written as 0 to a because a is the period plus a to 2a plus 2a to 3a, right, plus n a to n plus 1a and so on up to the infinity we have. So, and so on. So, here the integral will become integral 0 to a e to power minus px fx plus integral a to 2a e to power minus px fx dx and so on. So, this can be written as summation n is equal to 0 to infinity integral from na to na plus 1a, right, of e to power minus px fx dx. Now, when we put x is equal to x is equal to, let x is equal to y plus n. If you take the substitution, x is equal to y plus n a. So everywhere you just put x in place of the x, you put n a. So when the x is equal to n a, when x is equal to n a, right? So n a and n a cancel out. Y is equal to zero. Here the limit y is equal to zero. When x is equal to n plus 1 a, right, n a, so n a is cancelled with this n, so y will become the a. So here the limit will be the limit integral 0 to a e to power minus p x is equal to y plus n a, and f x is equal to f of the y plus n a into dy, right? From here you will get the dx is equal to dy. So into dy, and this can be written as summation n is equal to 0 to infinity integral 0 to a e to power py minus e to power minus n p a f of y plus n a into dy. And since f is what? Periodic function with period, right? F is periodic function with period a. So f of y plus n a will be the f of y. So we have written here summation n is equal to 0 to infinity integral 0 to a e to power minus p y e to power minus n p a and f of y dy. So these quantities are free from the n, that can be written as outside the summation. So integral 0 to a e to power minus p x fx, just you change the y to x. So integral 0 to a e to power minus p x fx dx summation from n is equal to 0 to infinity e to power minus n p a. So when n is equal to 0, when n is equal to 0, it is 1. When n is equal to, right, n is equal to 1, it is e to power plus e to power minus p a plus e to power minus 2 p a plus e to power minus 3 p a. And it is what? It is the geometric series, infinite geometric series with the common ratio e to power minus p a, right? So it's infinite sum. So its infinite sum will be the 1 upon 1 minus r. So 1 upon 1 minus e to power minus p a. So that will become the fp. Fp is equal to 1 upon 1 minus e to power minus p a integral 0 to a e to power minus p x f x into dx. That is the Laplace transform for the periodic function. If fx is given to you x square, if fx is given to you x square with x is equal to 0 to 2 and f of x plus 2 is equal to fx, right? F of x plus 2 is equal to fx. So it is periodic with period 2, right? So means what is the question? It is a 0, 2, 4, 6, minus 2. So between 0 to 2, we have the curve x square, right? Between 2 to 4, we have the curve. Between 4 to 6, we have the curve, right? Like this, we have the curve. So this is the periodic function. Now you have to determine the L of the fx. L of the fx means direct formula. We know that it is the 1 upon 1 minus e to power minus p a. A is equal to 2. So 1 upon 1 minus e to power minus 2 p integral 0 to 2. 0 to a means 0 to 2 e to power minus p x fx into dx. And fx is what? It is the x square. Right, so integral 0 to 2 e to power minus px into x square, and on integration you will get this. Clear? So in this way, we compute the Laplace transform of the Laplace transform of periodic function. Now, last question. Solve x y double dash plus 2x plus 3y dash plus x plus 3y is equal to 3 into e to power minus x. Initial condition is given to you, y 0 is equal to 0. So simple, all this type of the question already we have done. We take the Laplace transform on both side. Laplace transform on both side, Laplace transform on both side. Taking Laplace transform on both side, since Laplace transform follow the linear property, it can be written as Laplace of the x y double dash plus 2 into Laplace of x y dash plus 3 into Laplace of the y dash plus Laplace of x into y plus Laplace of the y. 3 into Laplace of the y is equal to 3 into Laplace of the e to power minus x. So Laplace of the y double dash is what? P square L of y minus p y at 0 and minus y dash at 0. And due to the multiply of the x, we take the minus d by dp of this. Minus d by dp of this plus 2 L of x into y dash. So due to the x, we take the here also we have the minus d by dp. Minus d by dp of p l y minus y at naught plus 3 into means l of y dash p of l y minus y naught minus l of Laplace of the x into y. So minus d by dp of the l y plus 3 l y is equal to 3 upon p plus 1. Right, Laplace of the e to the power minus x is 1 upon p plus 1. Now it is given to you y naught is equal to 0. So y naught is equal to 0. So this is 0. This is 0. This is 0. And L of y we are writing as a capital Y. L of y we are representing as a capital Y. So because this is independent of p, it will become on derivative, it will become 0, and at the rest place there is no y dash. So this will become minus d by dp of p square ly minus 2 d by dp of p ly plus 3 p of ly minus d by dp of ly plus 3 ly plus 3 upon p plus 1, or minus d by dp of, just to combine this, minus d by dp of and minus d by dp of. So as you combine, it will give you minus d by dp of p square ly plus 2 p ly plus ly is equal to 3 upon p plus 1 minus 3 into p of ly minus 3 of ly. Let L of y is equal to capital Y is equal to fp. So minus d by dp of the p square capital Y plus 2py plus y is equal to 3 upon p plus 1 minus 3py minus 3y. Just for easiness, we have written the capital Y, that thing. L of y as a so on differentiating, right, it will give you 2py plus p square dy by dp. On differentiating this, you will get the on differentiating the py, you will get the y plus p into dy dp. So y plus p into dy dp, and derivative of this is the dy dp. And on this side we have the 3 common. So here we have the 1 upon p plus a minus py minus y. So again, if you take the dy dp common, so we have the minus dy dp of p square plus 2p plus 1 is equal to 3 upon p plus 1 minus 3py minus 3y plus 2y plus 2py. So which on solving will give you 3 upon p plus 1 minus p plus 1 y. So we have the dy dp, right? We have the minus dy dp is equal to 3 upon p plus 1 cube minus y upon p plus 1. And what is this? This is the linear first order differential equation, right? This is the linear equation. So for the linear equation, what is the solution? First we compute the integrating factor e to the power minus integral p dx, and then after we have the solution as a solution as y integrating factor is equal to integral q integrating factor plus c. So it will give you integrating factor, right? Integrating factor as a 1 upon p plus 1. So it will give you solution as a y into 1 upon p plus 1 integral minus 3 upon p plus 1 cube into 1 upon p plus 1. That is the 1 upon p plus 1 cube. Right? So that is the y. Here we do not write the c. If you write the c, that will come the 0 by the initial condition. We are not writing, but if you write, then that will become the 0 on the initial condition. So y is equal to 1 upon p plus 1 whole square. And what is this y? This is the L of y. So if you have to compute the small y is the L inverse of 1 upon p plus 1 whole square. And that is the standard. It is the x into e to the power minus x. So this time, convolution is important topic of the Laplace transform. But this time, due to the scarcity of the time, we have not included this in the course. So now that part is I'm skipping. Now next chapter is system of equation. So in the chapter 3 you have studied many properties of the second order differential equation. So it is the same theorem, same statement, same thing you will study here also. So let system of equation, if today we will study only the theorems. If y1 y2 yn are unknown function of a single independent variable x, then their derivative y1 dash y2 dash yn dash are explicitly given function of x y1 y2 yn, that is y1 dash is explicit function of x y1 y2 yn, y2 dash is explicit function of x y1 y2 yn, and yn dash is equal to explicit function of x y1 y2 yn. So this is known as the system of equation. Here we have the n derivatives y1 dash y2 dash yn dash, which are the explicit function of x y1 y2 yn. So this type of the system are known as the system of equation. Now, nth derivative equation, any nth derivative equation, single equation, can be represented as, can be represented as system of equation. Any, for example, second order differential equation can be represented as system of equation having the two equations, right? So any nth order differential equation can be represented as system of equation. So what is the general form of the nth order differential equation? Nth order differential equation consists the independent variable, dependent variable, and all order derivatives. And all order derivatives. In general, nth order differential equation is explicit expression of independent variable, dependent variable, and all other order derivative. So this single equation are treated as special case of the system of equation. System equation is advanced one. Nth order single equation can be represented as system of equation. So how we can write? So for that, just you put y1 is equal to y, y2 is equal to y dash, yn is equal to y nth derivative n minus 1th derivative of y, right? So we say that and observe that 2 is equivalent to the system. 2 is equivalent to the system means now always we write the system in the curly bracket, right? Always you write the system as a curly bracket. So in because it represents the one system having the n equation and it represents the system, right? So y1 dash is equal to y2. Means y1 dash is equal to y2. That is what? It is the f1, explicit function. Explicit function of y1, y2, yn. Y2 dash is equal to y3 means it is the explicit function of y1, y2, yn. Right? Similarly, x also. Similarly, yn dash, it is the explicit, it is the function of the x, y1, y2, yn. Right? So it means you have taken general nth order differential equation and you have by proper substitution, you have written that as a system of equation. Right? Having the n equation. So here, this four is a special case of the first. Special case of the first, right? First means this is the general equation. This is the most general equation. So four is the special case of the first. Means main thing is any order differential equation can be represented as system of equation of n equations. Now we have to determine the solution of this system of equation. Because for the general equation, we know how to determine the solution. Now from the system of equation, how we can write the solution. If yx is the solution of 2, means general equation. If yx is the solution of 2, then the y1x, y2x, ynx defined by the 3 satisfy the 4. Means it is the whatever the y1, y2, y3 you have defined here. Whatever the y1, y2, y3 you have defined here at this place. That will be the solution. That will be the solution of this 4, right? This 4, solution of this 4. So either you compute the solution of the single equation or you compute the solution of the system of equation. Both will give the same solution. Just it is the way of representation. Just it is the way of representation. But system of equation we treat as an advanced one. For example, let us understand with the example. Replace each following differential equation by equivalent system of first degree order equation. So what is the equation we have? Y double dash minus x square y dash minus xy is equal to 0. So let us assume y dash is equal to z. Let y dash is equal to z. And from the z we have the right, we z z dash. This is the z dash. Z dash will be the dz by dx. And what is the dz by dx? That is the dy dx of the dy by dx. That is the d2 y upon dx2. And d2 y upon dx2 is what? D2 y upon dx2 is what? It is the y double dash. Right? And y double dash from here will be the x square y dash plus xy. Plus xy. So, this will give you, this will give you z dash minus x square, and y dash is what? It is the z. So, z dash minus x square z minus xy. So, that can be written as dz by dx is equal to x square plus z plus xy. Means, this is nothing. This is equivalent to y dash is equal to z, and z dash is equal to x square z plus xy. That is the f1 of the x, y, z, and it is the f2 of x, y, z. So we have written the single equation in terms of the system of equation. Right? One equation is this one, y dash is equal to z. Another one is the z dash is equal to x square z plus xy. So, that can means single equation, second order differential equation can be written as system of equation. Let us take another example. Y triple dash is equal to y double dash minus x square y dash whole square. If we have this equation, assume let y dash is equal to z. Let y dash is equal to z. Y dash is what? D by dx. So, and let z dash is equal to y double dash, z dash is equal to y double dash, and this z dash we write, this z dash we write as a w. Let w is equal to, let w is equal to z dash or y double dash or y double dash. So, so, if you compute the w dash is what? It is the dw by dx, or this can be written as d2z upon dx2, or it can be written as d3y upon dx3. If you compute the w dash, it can be written as dw by dx, or y triple dash, or z double dash. So, from here, what is this? This is the w dash. What is this? This is the y double dash. That is the w, right? That is the w. And what is this? This is the z. This is the z. So, in this way, if you write, it will become w dash is equal to w minus x square, z square, right? And it means this system of equation, this this given differential equation can be written as system of equation y dash is equal to z, z dash is equal to w, and w dash is equal to w minus x square z square. Ultimately, it is what? F1 of x, y, z, w. It is what? F2 of x, y, z, w, and it is what? F3 x of y z w. So given nth order derivative equation, nth order differential equation can be written as system of equation, and the system of equation always we take the first order differential equation, right? In the system of equation always we take the first order differential equation. So this is the first order differential equation, first order differential equation, first order differential equation. Clear? Now, we start with the linear equation, because in the chapter 3, we have covered the second order linear equation. So, this is analogous of that. So, now we have the linear equation. So, consider the linear system of equation of two first order equation in two unknown function of the form. So we take the system of equation S. System of equation S, always you write the system of equation in the bracket because it represents the one equation. So dx by dt is equal to a1, a function of t, into x plus b1t y plus f1t. Dy by dt is equal to a2t into x plus b2t y plus f2t. So this is the linear equation. This is the linear system of equation. This is the linear system of equation. System of equation. Now we have to solve this. In general, we write, dx by dt or dy by dt is the explicit function of txy. Independent variable and two other variable. So here the independent variable is t. Right? Here the it is the independent variable. It is independent variable and these two are the dependent variable. Dependent variable. So this is the most general. The equation number one. Equation number one is most general linear equation. Linear equation, right? Where a1, a2, t, b1, b2, t, f1, f2, t are continuous function on AB, closed interval AB of the t-axis. Of the t-axis. Now, there, generally we have the equation, there we have the equation y double dash in the second order differential equation. We have the equation of the form y double dash plus px y dash plus qx y is equal to rx. If rx is zero, that equation is termed as a homogeneous equation. Homogeneous linear equation. This is the second order linear equation. If rx is equal to zero, then we say homogeneous equation. In the same fashion, if f1t and f2t are identically zero, first is called the homogeneous, otherwise it is called the non-homogeneous system of equation. We are correlating with the chapter 3. All the theorems, all the things we are correlating here. Now, we have the two dependent variable. So here we say solution of the first is of the form x is the function of the independent variable t and y is the function of the independent variable t. So x is equal to xt, y is equal to yt is the solution of the first. Now we will study the nature of the solution. Nature of solution. Now we have the sixth theorem. So all the six theorem we will study one by one. So there also we have studied these six theorem. In the chapter 2, chapter 3 also we have studied the sixth theorem. So first one is, or time is almost over. So it's better we start in the next class. But all the sixth theorem we cannot cover. So it's better we start in the next class. Right? Online any problem from the today lecture?
No, sir.
Thank you, Arjun.
Thank you, sir.